Good morning. We welcome you to this online worship service. This is the Sabbath day God has appointed us to worship the living God. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Shall we look to the Lord in prayer? Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for thy grace and mercy that we could come together in this manner to worship the living God, in whom we have life, the fullness of life, the abundant life, the everlasting life. We praise thee, Master, for the way you have protected us from all kinds of possible dangers and epidemic. Father, we pray that let your grace be sufficient to us, Lord, to worship thee in truth and spirit. As we worship thy triune God, the triune God, Father God, inspire us, Lord, to be an effective tool to worship thee in all our heart, in all our mind, in all our spirit, O Father. Bless the dear ones who are joining with us today morning. Be with us, Lord, and keep us in the center of your will. In Jesus' most matchless name we pray.
Jesus, stand among us in thy grace and power. Let this time of worship be a hallowed hour. Bring the Holy Spirit into every heart. Bring the cares and sorrows from each soul depart. Amen.
Shall we turn to 275 in the hymnal? Sweet Hour of Prayer, 275 in the hymnal. have the unison reading now is taken from book of Psalms, chapter 27. 27 in Psalms. We'll read this psalm together as unison. The Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked advance against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. An army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then I will be confident. One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord, and to seek Him in His temple. For in the day of trouble, He will keep me safe in His dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of His sacred tent, and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At His sacred tent, I will sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Hear my voice when I call, Lord. Be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says to you, seek His face. Your face, Lord, I will seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my helper. Do not reject me or forsake me. God, my Savior. Though my father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, O Lord. Lead me in a straight path. Because of my oppressors, do not turn me over to the desires of my foes. For false witness rise up against me, shouting malicious accusations. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart, and wait for the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end.
The time to look into God. God is His face, and this is a rare opportunity for the human being to seek the Lord at all times. Now this is the privilege, God given privilege, for every one of us to ask God to forgive all our sins and trespasses, and definitely God will protect us from all kinds of possible dangers. And when we pray, God is so faithful to forgive all our sins and trespasses. And if there is any sins which is found in our heart and mind, we will ask God to forgive all our sins and trespasses. And our sins will be forgiven, and we will have the blessings from the eternal God, Almighty Father. Shall we look to the Lord in prayer? Because God will never despise the broken and contrite heart. Let's look to the Lord in prayer. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Master, for the privilege you have granted unto us to call you Abba Father. Father God, even in the cross of Calvary, you have interceded for us to the Father to forgive all our sins. Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. Father, we praise thee, Lord, for enabling us to inherit the forgiveness of sins through Christ Jesus, the blood that has been shed on the cross 2000 years ago. The blood of Abel speaks, and the blood of Jesus also speaks. What more than what was spoken by the blood of Abel? We praise thee, Master, for enabling us to come unto thy presence, because the blood of Christ prevails us, Lord. We thank you, Master, for forgiving all our sins and trespasses. Father God, if the sins are like scarlet, it will be like a wool. And Father, we praise Thee, Master, for the sacrifice You have made on the cross through Thy only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, who is going to come to take the church bride as a bride. Father, that time, as we know, the time will delay no longer. You are at hand. We praise Thee, Master, for the fear of God You have imparted upon us to lead a blameless life, to forsake all the filthy habits we had, and to please You and You alone. Father, in this special auspicious moment, we commit our ways and deeds unto Thee, O Lord. We surrender ourselves unto Thee, O Master. Father God, if there is any sins which is not pleasing in Thy sight, which is abomination in Thy presence, Father, forgive us, Lord, and cleanse us by the precious blood of the Lamb. And Father, we thank You, Master, for the blessings You have, manifold blessings You have bestowed upon each and every one of us to come together in this manner as a family together. This is the time, the quarantine period, You have permitted, O Lord, to come closer unto Thee. Father God, to prepare ourselves for the great awakening of the churches in the days to come. Father, we praise Thee, Master, for Thy sustaining grace that has sustained us from every possible harm and every possible diseases. Father God, in spite of all our weaknesses, limitations and shortcomings, You are the God who is with us as Emmanuel. You are never ashamed of calling us Your children, O Master. Father God, You have called Yourself as God of Abraham, Isaac and Jacob. And You are the God, You are the God of us too, O Father. We praise Thee, Master, for the privilege You have granted unto us to be united together as a family unit. Father God, many people, they are no more now. We have seen them in the last year, even in the church. They are good people, O Master, and they are no more now. And Father God, it gives a lesson for us to humble ourselves. And You are the God who has engraved us on Thy palms, O Lord. We belong to You. And for us, nothing to exalt, nothing to boast on our side, O Master, because we are already broken, O Master. We don't know what is happening and what is going to happen to us and what is going to happen to the society and the people whom You call. Father, You are in control. Keep us, Lord, in the center of Your will as we, the redeemed children, redeemed community. Father God, help us, Master, to live a life which is pleasing unto Thee, pleasing unto Thy sight, O Master. Father God, you are the God who has enabled us to have the identity with the Son of God, the Savior of this world. And You have made us, Lord, the salt and the light of this earth. And we have received the heavenly Shekinah glory in the earthen vessel, O Father. Let the earthen vessel be protected, O Master. Father God, we are expected to give account unto Thee. The days are fast approaching, O Master, with the trembling fear and, Father God, the fear of God, the godly nature. We are coming unto Thy presence, O Father. Be gracious unto us. Have mercy upon us, Lord. And we hope that You are the God who breaks every yokes and chains. As the waters break out, You have already broken out all our enemies before us. Help us, Lord, to celebrate the victory over all our enemies. The wicked enemy, O Father, he was already condemned on the cross, O Master. We praise Thee, Lord, for the deliverance You have granted unto us. Deliverance over the sin, over death, over the curses, over the infirmities, and deliverance over the work of the flesh, and salvation over the spirit of this world. We magnify Thy name as we meditate upon Your word. Father, as we sit unto thy feet, O Master, help us, Lord, to see the exalted God who is seated on the throne, highly exalted. As Moses, the servant of the Most High, could see the glory of God in the Mount Sinai. Father, we pray, O Lord, inspire us, Master. Let the Holy Spirit fall afresh upon us. Let the Holy Spirit break every yokes and chains found in our jurisdiction, O Master. Father God, let all the strongholds of the devil be completely demolished by the power of the risen Lord in Jesus' name. Thank you, Master, for being with us as the fire, holy fire. Let the fire consume every dark forces. We praise thee, Master, for using us mightily for the extension of thy kingdom in the given provisions, given available opportunity. We praise thee, Master, as a family together, we come unto thy presence. Father, touch our hearts and minds, O Master. Let the word be preached to our hearts, O Lord. Let our hearts be edified. Let our minds and all the organs of our body and its activities be refreshed by the power of the Holy Spirit, O Master. Be with us, Lord. We do remember the church whom you call, especially the church at large, the church triumphant, the church militant. Father, in a special way, we commit to all the members of the Borivali Methodist English Church. Protect them, Lord. Thus far you have protected, and still we beckon to thee, O Master, to protect all the families, O Master. Let the families be safe. Thank you, Lord, for the way you have led the senior members of our church, people who are well advanced in years. Father, they need the proper restoration of their sight. They need their proper strength, O Master, in their physical body. Father God, let them be able to do their assigned duties and responsibilities without the help of others, O Master. And wherever they are, let them feel thy presence, let thy grace be made available unto them to do the assigned task, O Master. Thank you, Master, for answering all our prayers. We pray for the elders of the church. We pray for the edification and growth of the church. We pray for the godly people in the church. We pray for the widows. We pray for the Father God, Sunday school children and the parents, the teachers who are molding the children. Bless one and all. Thank you, Master, for the people who are attaining the age to get married, to find the right partner in their life, to be united together in the holy matrimony. Be with them, Lord, and provide their way for them, and let them lead a family life with values, O Master. Father God, the things which is not pleasing in thy sight, help us, Lord, to forsake all such things and have the fear of God in our hearts and minds. Ultimately, we are called to proclaim thy good news. We are called to inherit the kingdom of God. We are called to propagate the message you have granted unto us through Christ Jesus, O Master. Be with us, Lord. We pray for the apex body of Methodist Church in India, and all the bishops and all the caretakers and all the officers. Father God, let all the dear ones who have, let them have the fear of God in their hearts as they are entrusted the responsibility of evangelizing gospel with the social action. Father God, let the whole area of the ministry be guarded by the Spirit of the living God. Let thy people be glad and rejoice in worshipping thee, O Master, as the days are fast approaching to celebrate Reverend John Wesley, who has brought the Methodist Church in India in an expanded way so far. Bless all their efforts, O Master. Bless all the churches together. We thank you, Master, for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. Father God, we pray for the parachurch organizations, non-government organizations, and the volunteers who are really in the forefront of the war between the coronavirus and the people of God. Father God, in ancient days, the servant of the high God, the Eliza, stood in front of 850 Baal worshippers. Father, ultimately, finally, you have granted victory unto the prophet, the man of God. Father, we pray, O Lord, let the coronavirus be wiped out from the face of this earth. Let the people be protected from all harms, O Father. Let the people have the normal life. Let the people become normal life, O Master. Be with us, Lord, and particularly, Father God, let the people who are not having the basic resources, essentials, and they are going from one place to another place to settle, to find a way out, livelihood. Father, make all their provisions for them, O Father, and let them be protected. Father, we thank you, Master, for the doctors, the nurses, the health workers, and all the volunteers and all the protective force of all the governments of various nations. Bless all their efforts, O Father. Father, ultimately, you are the God who is going to hoist the flag of victory in all the nations of this earth, O Father. Bless one and all. We are waiting to hear the message from you, O Lord. Let the message touch our hearts and minds, touch our bones, touch all the organs of our bodies. Help us, Lord, to be edified, to empower the people whom you call. We surrender ourselves unto thy loving care. Bless us, Master, as we listen thy word. Let thy miracle happen in the lives of thy people, O Master. Be with us, Lord. The things which we have asked, which we have not asked, be granted unto us for thy glory and for the edification of the church. Thank you, Master, for answering our prayers. We give you all glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' most matchless name, who taught us to pray, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever and ever. Amen. The time for the scripture reading. Read the scripture. The first portion is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 60, verses from 1 to 5. And the second reading is from the epistle of Apostle Paul to Ephesian church, to Ephesians 6, chapter 6, verses from 10 to 18.
The first reading is taken from Isaiah, chapter 60, verse 1 to 5. Isaiah, chapter 60, verse 1 to 5. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the people. But the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to you, come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Lift up your eyes and look about you. All assemble and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters are carried on the hip. Then you will look and be radiant. Your heart will throb and swell with joy. The wealth on the seas will be brought to you. To you the riches of the nations will come. Here ends the first reading.
Amen. Second reading is taken from book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verses 10 to 18.
Today's Bible reading is taken from Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 10 to 18. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the power of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground, and after you have done everything, to stand. Stand firm then, with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, Take up the shield of faith, with which you can extinguish all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen. Shall we affirm our faith by saying the Apostle Creed, found in 738 at the back of the hymnal, the Apostle Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty, and thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now we'll have the second hymn, 221, standing on the promises of God, 221. It will bring blessings unto us as we meditate the word of God, as we listen the word of the Lord. Definitely we will feel the difference in all our being. The title I have chosen today for today's meditation, darkness covers the earth, but the Lord rises upon you. Darkness, everywhere we see the dark forces, the effect of dark forces. All of a sudden, human beings are being collapsed. So this is the cause of dark forces. And the dark forces leads the people to tribulation. Tribulation generally is inevitable for every Christian. We have to go through the sorrows, struggle, tribulation. That's how Jesus instructed his followers, in this world you shall have tribulation, but I have overcome this world. It is in John 16:33. So tribulation is inevitable. We cannot escape from the tribulation. Job 30:26 says he was waiting for the good things to see. He said, when I hoped for good, evil came. When I looked for light, the darkness came. It is beyond his expectation. His anticipation was to see the light. He was hoping for good to be done. But when he looked for good, it was not being given. And the darkness came. Isaiah 62 says, the darkness covers the earth. Darkness covers the whole earth. Thick darkness is over the people of all the nations in the form of now coronavirus. The virus has become a major topic for each and every human being who are under the sun. Virus, the cause of virus, the effect of virus. It covers the whole earth now. Verse 62 says, Isaiah 62 says, darkness covers the earth in the form of COVID-19. Thick darkness is over the people. Don't need to worry. But what God says, how God says, the Lord rises upon you. The Lord rises upon you in spite of all the effect of dark forces is seen in the lives of the people. His glory appears over you. The glory of God will be seen on you. Forget about the dark forces and the work of the dark forces. It will be completely wiped out, wiped away. It will be eradicated. It will be completely removed from the face of this earth, and the glory of God will be seen on you. You will be filled with the glory of God. The Lord Jesus will rise upon you. He rises upon you. That's the encouraging word we see today found in Isaiah 60 verse 2. Romans 13:12 says, therefore cast off all the work of dark forces. Cast off the work of darkness. Paul says, we don't need to worry about the dark forces, the effect of dark forces, how it creates, how it disturbs the family, how it keep the people under stress and frustration. But what we have to cling unto what God says. The glory of the Lord will overshadow you. The glory of the Lord will appear over you. 1 Peter 5:8 says, this is a kind of devil. Devil is disturbing. His work is always disturbing. And people are distracted. People are disturbed because of the dark forces created by the devil. The work of the devil. 1 John 3:8 says, Jesus the Son of God came to destroy the work of the devil. We have the supporting evidence that Jesus has come to destroy the work of the devil. his main ministry, his earthly ministry is mainly focused on the destruction of the enemy. That's how Jesus said, I have come to destroy the work of the devil. Yes, we are born to destroy the work of devil. Work of the devil. Romans 16:20 says, the Lord of peace shall bruise Satan under your feet shortly. Lot of messages we have received. Every now and then we are encouraged by the word of the Lord. Promises by God. I will crush the devil under your feet. This is the promise God has made for us. Romans 16:20. 1 John 4:4 says, we are the conquerors. Children, you are the conquerors. Because the one who is in us is greater than one who is in the world. That's how we are labeled as conquerors. 1 John 4:4 says, we are the conquerors. Children, you are the conquerors. You are the victorious people. Your victory is already at hand. God has already earned the victory on the cross by crushing the head of Satan. He is crushed and he will be no more. To be victorious, we need to equip ourselves with two godly characters. If we have that two characters, definitely we will be victorious and we will destroy the work of the devil. First one is unshakable faith in God. Unshakable faith, not a half-hearted faith. Unshakable faith in God. Second thing, demonstration of faith in action. Demonstration of unshakable faith in action. Sometimes when we face the trials and temptation, when we face sorrows, the tribulation, the confusion, we should not lose our heart. Because it is there, it is appointed for every human being. Jesus has already said, in this world, the world is like that. In this world, you have to go through such tribulation. You cannot escape from the tribulation. But ultimately, the Holy Spirit, God says, I will hoist the flag of victory in every battles you are undertaking. And we have the hope that God is fighting for us. Now, to be victorious, we need to show the unshakable faith in God. How can we show the unshakable faith? Jesus says, John 14:12, he who believes in me, the works that I do, and they will do even greater things than what I do. When we trust God, when we put all our belief on God, we will be able to do more than what Jesus did on this earth. And it's a soothing. It gives some sort of boost to our soul. And Ephesians 6:12 says, yes, we are empowered to do greater and mighty things in the name of God. What do we do and how do we do? Most of the time we are dejected. While looking at the things, what is happening in and around us, we lose our heart, we are dismayed. God says, fear not, for I am with you, do not be dismayed, for I am your God. You put all your trust on me, your faith will never be shaken. You cast all your worries on me. Jesus, every now and then, his word encourages to be bold enough to face the reality. And now, Ephesians 6:12. Yes, we are empowered to do good. How are we? Let's introspect ourselves. How do we do? What do we do? How do we do? Ephesians 6:12 says, our drawback is flesh and blood. Flesh is weak. Blood is also weak. And we are the weak creatures. We are known by our weakness, limitations and shortcomings. That's how Jesus exhorted to the Ephesians, Paul exhorted to the Ephesian churches, the flesh is weak, flesh and blood. Our struggle is not against flesh and blood. Of course, we are struggling with the flesh. As long as the blood of human being is in the flesh, We have to face the tribulation. We have to face the struggle. Whether we like it or not, it is bound. And Jesus says, the struggle is not on the basis of flesh and blood, but against rulers, rulers of the nations, authorities, powers of the dark forces, dark world. And our struggle is against spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. So physical warfare is there, spiritual warfare is there, mental warfare is there. And every day, Sitzen Lebanon, every day the life situation, the scene created by the politicians, created by the leaders, and created by the authorities. That's how it is illustrated. Our problem, our struggle is not only with the flesh and blood, our struggle is on so many things. In spite of all such things, we are expected to show the unshakable faith. See, this is power rulers, authorities, powers of this dark world, and the spiritual faces of forces of evil. Luke 10:19 says, you are authorized. We are given authority to trample Satan, to stamp on Satan, to curse the Satan. The authority we have received from Jesus. Jesus himself says, you are empowered. We are given authority to trample Satan. We experience the wicked schemes of devil every now and then. Are we aware? 1 Peter 5:8. Every often we hear this word, roaring. The devil is a roaring lion. He is always coming around, roaring, trying to find whom he can devour. But at the same time, Acts 10:38 says, we have the Lion of Judah. We have the Lion of Judah. He is also coming around doing good and delivering the people who are under the clutches of devil. So we have the God who is Lion of Judah. Not necessary to worry about the ordinary lion, the voiceless lion, the teethless lion is already powerless. He has become already powerless. Luke 10:19, we are empowered. So we are in the battlefield of lost days. Now we know that we are in the warfare. We are in the battlefield. Everyone has to fight against such devil. Not only flesh and blood, powers and principalities and heavenly realms of evil. And we have to equip ourselves. To face the battle, the two things will happen. Whether to defeat the battle or be defeated. We will never be defeated because Christ died for us and he has given his authority unto us. And by his authority, we will be able to conquer sin and death. We will defeat the work of the devil. We will defeat devil. Ephesians 6:16 says, what do we do? To defeat the devil, we have to cultivate the unshakable faith. Unshakable faith. Our faith, every now and then, every often, it is shaken. If we face a problem, immediately it will shake. If you take an unexpected, some struggle, it will be shake. It is shaken. If you take unforeseen situation, unexpected, unavoidable situation, it is shaken sometimes. But we have to prove our unshakable faith. If we put our trust on God, our faith will never be shaken. That's how Jesus said, cast all your burden upon me. I will never suffer the righteous to be moved. You will never be shaken. We have to cultivate the unshakable faith. Because to be victorious, to defeat the work of the devil, we need to have the unshakable faith in God. And Ephesians 6:16, take up the shield of faith. Shield is required because the arrows comes, the arrows of fire initiated by the devil, it comes often to us. And we have to resist the arrows of fire comes from the devil. And to resist the arrows, what do? We need to have the shield. We need to have the shield. Shield of faith. Shield of faith. It will help us to extinguish all the flaming arrows of evil. Or it will help us that when we have the shield of faith, it will help us to extinguish all the flaming arrows of evil, caused by evil. So that's how we are given exhortation to put on the armor of God. Armor of God. One of the elements of the armor is shield of faith. And let's cultivate the shield of faith, because we are under threats every now and then. To overcome the threats, we need to shield us. We need to shield ourselves with faith. The first one is unshakable faith helps us to defeat the work of devil. Whatever the situation may be, when we look at the situation, we cannot achieve anything. Even the Esther, the Queen Esther, seeing the situation, she was perplexed. She was astonished and she was completely shocked. And at the one point of time, she jumped into the king's providence. If I die, let me die. God did not allow her to die. And her faith rescued her. Her faith has made her well. Her faith saved her. So unshakable faith helps us to defeat the work of devil. Second thing, demonstration of faith in action. Demonstration of unshakable faith. We have to show the faith we have in action. That's the thing. The second title, second subheading we take under this darkness covers the earth, but the Lord rises upon you. James 4:17 says, this faith is having two elements. This faith has two elements. What are the two elements? James 4:17. Submit ourselves to God. Submit yourself to God. And then second element is resist the devil. The output of demonstrating the unshakable faith is leading us into two things. We have to submit ourselves to God. Before we encounter devil, we need to submit ourselves to God. Then resist the devil. Resist the devil. How are we going to do? Satan, if you do that, Satan will flee away. Submit yourself to God and resist the devil. Satan will flee from you. That's the word of the Lord. Both elements are mandatory. Submission to the word of God, or submissiveness to God and resist the devil, is these two are mandatory in every Christian life. The fighting strategy, we learn a fighting strategy. Fight against the principalities and powers and the dark forces in the heavenly realm. There's a strategy we found. One, normally escape, defense and attack. We need to have the unshakable faith which will help us to escape. We need to have the unshakable faith which will help us to defend ourselves. That is the shield, protective shield. Shield of faith. And third one, protection is there, shield is there. And then we have to attack the devil. Attack the devil. These two we should go simultaneously. Mark 16:17 says, in my name you will drive out demons. In my name you will drive out demons. We need to take the name of Jesus to drive out demonic forces. We are protected because we have the unshakable faith, unshakable shield of faith. And having received the shield of faith, we should be ready to resist the devil, attack the devil. We should be alert. Fighting strategy, we see escape, defense and attack. Mark 16:17, Jesus says, in my name you will drive out demons. What is the source? Prayer in spirit, not ordinary prayer. Prayer in spirit, in all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. That's mentioned in Ephesians 6:18. Prayer in spirit, not an ordinary prayer, sitting in somewhere else and praying and thinking something and praying. Praying in the spirit is very much required to demonstrate the unshakable faith in our lives. Ephesians 6:10, 11, 12, 13 says, put on the armor of God. Put on the armor of God. There's a bunch of tools to defeat the work of the devil in an easy way, in an amicable way to defeat the work of the devil, armor of God. And there are several elements found in the armor of God. Tools to resist the devil. Few things I highlight which is mentioned in the armor of God. Few things. There are three things I will highlight. Three things. What are the things which will help us to defeat the work of the devil? Three main things. When we go through the struggles, when we are ready to face the battlefield, three things are required. We will see the three things. What are the three important things? It is if we have such three elements of the armor of God, we will be victorious and battle, because battle belongs to God, and we will be victorious. And this, let us analyze what are the three things which will help us to defeat the Satan and his work. Three main things. See three things from the armor of God to defeat the work of the devil. What are the three things? First one, Mark 16:17. In my name, you will drive out demons. In my name. Take the name of Jesus. If you take the name Jesus, we will be able to defeat the work of the devil. Because God the Father sent Jesus Christ to destroy the work of the devil. And when we support that, automatically it will be easy for us. Because God says, my yoke is easy. Isaiah 45:23 and Romans 14:11 says, every knee will bow before me. Every knee shall bow before me. Before my name. Use my name, Jesus. Three important things. Take the name of Jesus at all times, whether it is favorable or adverse situation. Take the name of Jesus, whether it is a time of confusion, time of joy and happiness. Take the name of Jesus. Because Jesus says, if you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it. So when we ask of his name, things will be done on its time. And he says, the exhortation is Jesus' name. Luke 10:19 says, I will give you authority to trample on snakes and scorpions. Jesus says, I will give my authority to trample on snakes and scorpions. You may come across the people with the habit of snakes and scorpions, and you will easily conquer such people. That's the battle, because ultimately the battle belongs to God. When you yield yourself to God, God will take care of your battle, and victory belongs to you. And first one, the name of Jesus. Second thing, Revelation 12:11, the blood of Jesus. First one, the name of Jesus. Second one, the blood of Jesus, to defeat the work of the devil. By the blood of Jesus, people triumphed over the devil who accuses the godly people day and night. The work of the Satan is accusing godly people. The force of the righteous will be condemned. That is written in the Bible. The force of the righteous. We are nobody to judge on anybody, on anything, on any issues. So that's how the word of the Lord helps us to, the blood of Jesus helps us to defeat the devil. And the third one, the word of God. First important thing is the name of Jesus. The more we handle, the more we use the name Jesus, we will be victorious. Second thing, the blood of Jesus. The more we use the blood of Jesus, we will be saved, we will be sanctified, we will be victorious, we will be able to defeat the work of the devil. And third thing, from the armor of God, by the word of God and testimony, they defeated Satan. Take the authority of the word of the Lord, because word of the Lord itself is an authority. It gives authority. It's a double-edged sword. It will touch the people with the truth. Said in Revelation 1:16 and 2:12. It is a double-edged sword. When we handle the word, it will correct us and correct the receptors, the listeners of the word of the Lord. Always use the word of God as a medicine to resolve any problem, to resist the devil, to demolish the dark forces, to wipe out the dark forces. We need to have the unshakable faith in Christ. Second thing, the demonstration of the unshakable faith in action. And under this heading, we have to submit ourselves to God and we have to resist the devil, evil. To do that, we need to have the armor of God. Especially in the armor of God, there are three important elements which will help us to defeat the work of the devil. The name Jesus and the blood of Jesus and the word of God. If we cling unto these three things, definitely we will be victorious. That's how it is written in Isaiah 62. Darkness covers the earth. Thick darkness over the people. But the Lord rises on you. The Lord rises upon you. And His glory will appear on you. The glory appears on you. This is the how we are so excited to hear the word of the Lord. Because in spite of all the adverse situation of dark forces, God says, I will appear over you. My glory will be seen on you. Word of the Lord says, Psalm 27:5, in the day of trouble, I will keep you safe. These are the day of trouble. These are the perilous days. I will keep you safe. In the day of trouble, I will hide you in the shelter of my sacred tent. And the day of trouble, I will set you high upon the rock. This is the promise God has granted us. May God help us to be victorious. Let's pray in the spirit, put on the faith, and let the faith we have be demonstrated in action by putting ourselves on the armor of God. May God help us to be victorious. Help us to defeat the work of the devil. Help us to exhibit. Help us to manifest the glory in and through our life. May God bless each and every one of us. Amen. Amen. We have a few announcements. As per the Methodist Church in India calendar, we observe Reverend John Wesley's Sunday on 24th May 2020. That is coming Sunday. Kindly pay your pledges, offertory, by online transfer to church account. The greetings, 15th of May, Mr. Moses Maxfield, and 19th of May, Master Taran Joshi, 22nd of May, Mrs. Anlet Baby Arapura, and the wedding anniversaries, 18th of May, Mrs. Hema Jeyarajan and Reverend Jeyarajan, 19th of May, Mr. Sassy Johnson and Mrs. Shalini Johnson, 23rd May, Mr. A. Daniel Paul and Mrs. Priya Jacinth Daniel. May God bless the dear ones who are entering into the special days. May God grant them long and healthy life. Loving Father, we thank you for the blessings you have bestowed upon the dear ones who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries. Father God, be gracious unto them and grant them, Lord, the heart's desire in Christ Jesus. let them be used as a mighty vessel for the glory of yours and the edification growth of the church, O Master. Grant them long and healthy life. Thank you, Master, for the blessings you have bestowed upon these dear people. Bless one and all. In Jesus' name. Amen. We will sing hymn 92, Amazing Grace. And then... reminded us to be victorious. Father God, the darkness covers the earth and the thick darkness covers over the people of all the nations, but yet the God's glory will be seen on us, Lord. That's the promise you have granted unto us. The glory of God will be seen on us. The Lord rises upon us. Father, we praise thee, Master, for that promise you have granted unto us. In spite of all the adverse situation, there is something precious yet to happen. We praise thee, Master, for thy glory that has been revealed through thy word in this morning. Fill us, Master, with thy spirit, O Lord. Father God, to be victorious, to defeat the dark forces, we need to have the unshakable faith in Jesus. Help us, Lord, to portray the unshakable faith in all the areas of our lives, O Lord. And help us, Master, to demonstrate the faith we have in Jesus in action. Father God, for that we are expected to put on the armor of God. To put on the armor of God, we need to have three elements so far. Father, we cling unto thee, O Lord. Help us, Lord, to take the name of Jesus at all times to defeat the work of the devil. And help us, Lord, to be cleansed by the precious blood of the Lamb and always take the blood of Jesus to defeat the work of the devil. And Lord Jesus, we need to have the word of God in our hearts and minds by which we will be able to destroy the work of the devil. Thank you, Master, for this time of worship together. Bless the dear ones who have made this time convenient to worship thee in this manner, online worship. Father, bless one and all. We pray for the sick people. We pray for the people who are, Father God, settling in the abroad from our church. Be with them, Lord, in a special way. We pray for the migrant laborers who are like wandering Aramians. Satisfy all their needs, O Master. As a church, we pray for the needy people, O Master. Let the coronavirus be completely wiped out, eradicated from the face of all the earth, O Father. We give you all glory, honor, and praise. Thank you, Master, for this time of worship. Thank you, Lord, for answering our prayers. Send us, Lord, with your heavenly richest benediction. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father Almighty, and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you both now and forevermore. Stay safe, stay protected.